Good morning, good morning. Come on, put those hands together and give him some praise. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Come on, somebody say, he is risen. He is risen indeed.
Oh, glory to the new born.
Come on, let's celebrate. Because he lives. Let us pray. Loving and gracious God, we celebrate you this morning. We celebrate your goodness and your mercy, your kindness, Father. We celebrate, Lord God, being able to call you Father. And you call us sons and daughters, Father. Lord, we don't take it for granted. We know that we are blessed. We know that we are highly favored of you, Father. We just give you all the praise and all the glory this morning for being, celebrate you. We glorify you in this place this morning. We invite your presence big and huge in our lives today. Not only today, but Lord God, in the following days, we celebrate you. We love you, Lord God. We give you all honor. Lord God, we lift up our this morning. We celebrate them this morning. We thank you, Lord God, for every one of them in this place. We thank you, Father God, for their contribution to this worship service. We leaders, Lord God, help them, Lord God, to praise you and to love you and to do all unto your glory. Lord God, and even as we leave this place today and as we assemble with family and assemble with friends, Father God, help us to celebrate, Father, that you are alive. That you walk with us and that you talk with us. That you lead us and you guide us, Father God. And that the comfort of your Holy Spirit heals us and helps us in our downtrodden moments, Father God. Lord God, we celebrate and we thank you, Father God, for being our successor, Father. For sitting at the right hand of the Father. For interceding us with moans and groans, Lord God. For speaking as our advocate, Father God, when we fall short of your glory, Lord God. When we stand in the need of prayer, Father God, we thank you for being an advocate for the God. Lord God, we also celebrate that you are preparing a place for your word says where you will be, we will be there also. So we celebrate these things, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh God, we love you today.
Yes, Jesus.
We honor you, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
We praise you, Father God.
To your name, Jesus.
We cannot do anything
without you, Father.
So we ask, Lord, that you come now. Continue to be with us in this worship service. Flow through the pews, Father God. Touch those who may not be feeling well, Father. We pray, Lord God, that you touch those who are at home, who are watching online. Let us know, Father God, that you are right there with us. Your word said you never leave us and never forsake us. Glorify you, Father, in this place always. We pray, oh God, that as our pastor comes and as he speaks your word, that you would just let your Shekinah glory just rest upon him, Father, that he may proclaim the good news of the resurrection of your life. We give you all praise, glory, and honor in the precious name of Jesus. Amen.
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 You have done.
Let us receive our children as they come forward this morning. Come on, y'all can do better than that. Come on, encourage them. Coming back. sick bed? How many of you know that the risen Savior, he's coming back? He's coming back.
H is for his life. Jesus Christ gave up his life to pay for the sins of all people because he loved us. He gave something important so we wouldn't have to.
E is for everlasting life.
God promised this to everyone who has faith in Jesus Christ. People who follow the words of Jesus will get to live with God forever.
L is for love. So God loved the world. He gave his only begotten Son, whoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
I is for if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit who dwells in you.
V is for victory. God gives believers victory over death and sin through the death and resurrection of his Son Jesus Christ. The Bible says, "Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ."
E is for eternity. God says we could live forever with him if we follow Jesus Christ. And eternity never ends and includes when we are alive and after we die.
S is for sacrifice. Jesus Christ gave his life to pay for the sins of all people because he loved us. He gave us something important so we wouldn't have to.
He lives! He lives! Jesus lives!
Thank you. mommy.
This morning. You touched our hearts this morning. You touched our hearts this morning. Because you're the future of this church. You're the fruit of us. Amen. Amen. Beautiful job. Beautiful job. God bless the children. God bless the children. God bless the children. Excellent. God bless the children. Amen. I wish I could take every last one of y'all home with me, but I don't know if that'll work. Good morning, St. Paul. In person and also online. We're so glad that you're here today to celebrate the risen Savior. Amen. The scripture lesson for today is going to come from the New Testament, the book of Luke, the 24th chapter, 1st through the 8th verses. New Testament, book of Luke, 24th chapter, 1st through the 8th. Verses. You may stand if you're able. Luke 24, verses 1 through 8. And it reads, "On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they had prepared. They went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly, two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, 'Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen. Yes. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee? The Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners, be crucified, and then on the third day be raised again.'" Verse 8. "Then they remembered his words." Then they remembered his words. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be unto God.
God bless you. You may be seated. Amen.
Still works, and I'm glad to.
to report that it's never lost. Still works, and I'm here to testify. God is not dead, He's still alive. The same blood that was shed way back at Calvary is the same blood that's working now for me. Oh, His blood redeems me from the stain of sin. And His blood, it cleanses me deep down within. So if you ask me how I made it and how I overcome, I can tell you it's because of the blood.
But still once, and I had to report that it's never lost
its power. For a minute.
Oh,
oh, glory to God, y'all.
Of Jesus.
Oh, 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 the blood.
Oh, the blood.
Oh, the blood.
Of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus. And it's still work.
your mama told you, not what your daddy told you. Anybody know for yourself that the blood still works? Hallelujah.
Come on, let's give God some praise all over the sanctuary. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that the blood still works. Amen. Amen. If you plead the blood of Jesus over your life, God will in fact show up and do awesome things in your life. It's a blessing to see each and every one of you in worship this morning on this Resurrection Sunday. Let's give God some praise for Jesus. Amen. Amen. My brothers and sisters, today is Resurrection Sunday. Resurrection Sunday, a day of renewal and hope, reminds us of the profound power of rebirth and transformation. It teaches us that amidst the trials and tribulations of life, there lies the potential for renewal, growth, and new beginnings. As we celebrate this day, let us embrace the spirit of resurrection by letting go of what no longer serves us and stepping into a brighter, more hopeful future. May the story of resurrection inspire you to rise above challenges, renew your faith, and brighten your path with love, compassion, and grace. Again, I say happy resurrection to each and every one of you. Amen. Amen. My brothers and sisters, I just want to pause and just give kudos to Sister Nelson and our class leaders for doing such an amazing job last Sunday with our Class Leader Sunday. We had an awesome and an amazing time. I would love for you, if you don't know who your class leaders is, please get in touch with the church and we will in fact let you know who they are. We have some important information to share from you and to receive from you. So we thank and praise God for you. Congratulations to all of you. You have made it through your 40 days of fasting. Amen. Somebody should have been running around the church with that one. Amen. Amen. I just want to tell you congratulations for doing such an awesome and amazing job. You may have fell off once or twice. Amen. That's all. Just once or twice. That's all. But you were able to get back up and get on it again. Amen. But you made it. Amen. Come on, give God some praise because you made it. Amen. Amen. And I want you to know I am praying for you and praying with you that whatever you pray for at the beginning of your fasting for God to do by today, I pray that God will, in fact, continue to work in your life to answer your prayer. Amen. Especially if it was something hard, something you really needed God to do. I pray that it will, in fact, happen for you because you were obedient in your fasting. Amen. Man, my brothers and sisters, for our Women's Day, we are still turning in our donations to the Women and Children's Shelter. Today is actually the last day to do so, but we're asking you to please donate if you have it or if you would still like to before you go to your Sunday Resurrection Sunday dinner. We are collecting white bath towels, paper towels, toilet tissue, laundry detergent pods, and we are doing our very best to support those who are in need. So please make your donations. And again, happy Women's Day month to all of our women on this last day of Women's History Month. Amen. We are also supporting a black business for this month. The black business that we are supporting is Top Shelf Creations, which is a home renovation company with a lot of experience in bathrooms, flooring, and paint. Please see Sister Jalise Blades the flyer so that you can get the details concerning this particular business. The Lay organization is looking for trailblazers, one trailblazer in particular from St. Paul to represent St. Paul for our upcoming recognition program. So I need one lay person by April the 4th. That's just a few days away. Somebody at St. Paul who may have blazed a trail, somebody who may have started something, somebody in our church who was the first to do something in our community to help those to come behind them. I need to know that name by April the 4th so that we can turn that name in and recognize them. Also, we are grateful for our Women's Day celebration, which is April the 14th, and we are looking forward to an awesome time of celebrating and honoring our women on that day. Amen. Before I move any further, let me pause and say thank you to everyone who had a hand in making sure that our young people participated and did an amazing job today in our worship experience. Amen. Come on, we can do better than that. Let's thank God for them. Amen. We thank God for all of you. Amen. We praise God for you. Our Bible study will begin again this Wednesday at 7 p.m. And our Women of Faith Bible study is Tuesdays at 7 p.m. We meet on our prayer call with Reverend Hamilton. I hope that you will please meet with me, with her, and all of our other ministry leaders as well. Monday, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays for our prayer call, 6 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. on those days. And on Monday, we have an extra time where you can meet us at 7 to 8 p.m. We have our Sunday school in the Woody Franklin Fellowship Hall at 9 a.m. every Sunday morning. And we are grateful because today we had a very spirited conversation. Amen. And we hope that you will take some time when you get an opportunity to join us for Sunday school. My beloved brothers and sisters, let us be in prayer for Brother Geese, Sister Gwen Dixon, Brother Larry and Doris Clay, Reverend Redding, Reverend Hurt's mother-in-law, Miss Sonia Rivy, Reverend Hamilton, Brother Nix, Brother Browner, and Sister Browner, and all those who are on our healed and delivered list. Let's keep them in our thoughts and prayers on today. Amen. And we thank God for all of you who have overcome. We praise God that God has, in fact, blessed you and has kept you. If we have any visitors with us, please stand at this time so that we can recognize you. Amen. Anyone visiting with us, won't you stand? Amen. 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 God bless you. We praise God for our visitors. Amen. We realize you could have gone anywhere to worship today, but you came to worship with us. Amen. I have some family here. Today is my sister's birthday. Amen. So she came and brought a whole lot of guests with her. Amen. Man, praise God for my family who's here. Won't we all stand all over the sanctuary? Won't we stand? Everyone stand. This is our seventh inning stretch. Amen. Won't you stand all over the sanctuary? Won't you greet your neighbor with a handshake, a hug, an elbow, a fist bump? Amen. Whatever you want to do, move across the worship experience, move across the sanctuary, and give somebody some love. Amen. 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 Amen.
Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you, the Jesus.
Jesus in you, the Jesus in me, loves the Jesus
so
in
easy.
You. So easy.
So easy. Give God another hand clap of praise all over this sanctuary as we move forward with our worship experience this morning. We want to remind everyone, unfortunately, we had the passing of one of our beloved members here at the church, Brother Eugene Costin, and we are going to keep him and his family in our prayers. The funeral will be April the 8th. Here at St. Paul Worship Center, Brother Eugene Costin, we're praying for his family. We also have a special presentation at this time for Miss Angela Ferrell. We're going to ask them to come forward. Here they come. Amen. Praise God.
We'd like for Angie to come up, please. We were a part of the committee that did the tea that was last month. And Angie took it upon herself. What she did was she sponsored all our little girls that were there. So if you were at the tea, they were sponsored by Miss Angie. And we would just like to say that's what St. Paul is a part of. You come here and you call them your church family. And that's where you refer to people as your church family. But then at some point, take family out. And you take church out, and we're just family. So speaking upon all the girls, we would like to tell Miss Angie, thank you so much for sponsoring them. They were absolutely beautiful.
Yeah,
the girls.
And our table won. Our table won for decoration. Thank you so much. If you were here and you attended the tea, please stand. If you attended the tea, please stand. Thank you so much.
Amen. We had a wonderful time, and again, thank you to all who supported that tea. It was absolutely amazing. We want to remind those who are going to give today that we have four ways to give. You can give using our Cash App, St. Paul Lithonia, $ St. Paul Lithonia, or you can give by texting the Paul to 73256. Or you can use our Realm giving through our website. You can always mail your offering in, amen. And our officers will be standing at the exit of our sanctuary to receive any physical offerings that you would like to give today. We always do a prayer, amen, unto God before we give. So let's bow our heads in a word of prayer, and I will ask if you would please repeat after me. Heavenly Father, I cheerfully and faithfully worship you with my tithes and offerings. This is not a debt that I owe, but a seed that I sow. I give it in love and I expect it to grow. I thank you for bonuses, promotions, and raises, for uninterrupted wages, for my labor, and for extraordinary favor, for borrowed money being returned, and generosity I did not earn, for canceled debt and unforeseen checks, for rebates, gifts, and blessings I didn't expect. Heavenly Father, somebody shout thank you for blessing my body, my mind, my family, and friends, and having a love for you that will never end. Come on, shout in the name of Jesus. By faith, I decree, as for me and my house, we walk in prosperity. Amen, amen, and amen. If you believe that, give God some praise. Amen.
He's a wonder. You thought I was to die for.
thought I was worth saving.
Yes, glory to God.
So you came and changed my life.
Yes, Lord.
You thought I was worth keeping.
Thank you, Lord.
So you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for. You thought I was to die for. Oh. You thought I was to die for. So you cleaned the fight, your life, so we could be free.
My sister made some baskets for all of our young people today. Amen. And some bags. Amen. And I have them here to my right. I need to give them to somebody to give to the kids. Amen. Amen. Somebody. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Give that to Sister Jalise. I think she'll be able to pass them. Thank you so much, Sora. Amen. Amen. If you would please turn with me to the Gospel of St. John, chapter 20. The Gospel of St. John, chapter 20. And we'll be reading verses 1 through 8. The Gospel of St. John, chapter 20. And we will be reading verses 1 through 8. And as you are turning in your Bibles or in your phones to that word, that scripture, I want to thank God for my mom who's here. Amen. She made it. Amen. She's been battling and fighting for a long time, but we're glad she's here. Amen. Amen. John chapter 20, verses 1 through 8. I'll be reading from the New International Version. When you have it, say amen. It says there, early on the first day of the week. That's where the preacher get early Sunday morning from. While it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. Amen. I want to focus on this particular verse. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. But as you go down, it says, verse 8, finally, the other disciple had reached the tomb first, also went in. So just because he outran Peter and got there first does not mean he went in first. I want to preach with an unorthodox sermon today from the subject, I have no competition. Amen. I have no competition. Amen. My brothers and sisters, Robert Roberts writes about a fourth grade class in which a teacher introduced a game called the balloon stomp. For this fourth grade class, he was doing a developmental exercise on the spirit of competition. He went into the fourth grade class and tied to the heel of every fourth grader a balloon. It was the simple object and directive of the game that you are to stump out other people's balloons. And whoever balloon was left tied to their ankle at the end would win. The competition is a zero-sum game. It is, in fact, a reflection of Darwin's survival of the fittest, because it suggested that if you win, somebody has to lose. Someone's success is dependent on someone else's failure. If you have to perceive that everyone around you is trying to get something that you have. Some within that fourth grade classroom tried to stand on the sideline to get out of the game. But even trying to stand on the sideline did not exonerate them from the competition. For those who were trying to win still met them on the sideline and stomped out their balloon. The one who won was secretly the most disliked member of the class, the one who was perceived and portrayed to be the class bully, because that student in that fourth grade class would do everything he could, from knocking students down, to elbowing them, to running them over, to do whatever he could in order to win, to stomp out their balloon. To bring a contrast to this experiment, Dr. Robert Roberts brought in a second fourth grade class. But this second fourth grade class was developmentally challenged, and they were given the same set of instructions as the prior class. But somehow they misread the instructions. They thought the object of the game was to get rid of the balloons and not to get rid of each other. So they changed the whole game. So when they were trying to stump out the balloons, if they could not stump out the balloon, the one who had a balloon still tied to their ankle would stand still and allow the other to stump out their balloon. And then they would switch places so that the other one could do likewise. The psychologists were confused because they did not know how to grade this behavior. Because what they were witnessing from the ones that were supposed to be developmentally challenged, different from the class that was supposed to be advanced, is that the class that was supposed to be developmentally challenged recognized that the enemy was not each other. They were just trying to get rid of the balloons. What am I saying, Pastor? What am I saying? I'm saying this to you because I am overtly concerned about the spirit of competition that exists within the church. And I don't mean necessarily St. Paul, but I mean the church as a whole. Because people are, in fact, becoming braggadocious about how many members they have and how good their choir sings and what building is the most state of the art. You don't even understand. Our competition ought not be against each other. Our competition ought to be against the kingdom of darkness. I got to compete with fools all day on my job. When I get to church, I don't have time to figure out who's got a Gucci bag or who's got a knockoff. When I come to church, I'm not trying to figure out whose hair is real and whose hair is fake. When I come to church, I come with one thing on my mind. Can God get the glory out of my life? Something has got to happen within the church where we stop competing with one another. My dear friends, there are three dimensions of competition. There is upwards comparison, there is downward comparison, and then there is a lateral comparison. Whatever state you're in, you're going to find yourself that you are in one of those three categories. You compare yourself with somebody who you perceive to be above you. That is upward comparison. But you got to be careful with upward comparison, because upward comparison causes you to miss out on gratitude. Because you are so consumed with what other people have that you forget to thank God what God has done for you in your life. The others have lateral comparison, that I am not judging myself with people who I perceive to be above me, but I am comparing myself with people who I think are on my level. Now, the problem with that is that leads you to complacency, because if the only litmus test of excellence you have are the people who are with you, you will never get to the next level. You got to find somebody who will, in fact, pull you up to the next place. And some of you got friends like that. They want you to maintain where they are. And as soon as you try to do something different, they try to drag you back down to their level and their place. Don't get mad at me because I want to go back to school, because I want to develop my gift, because I want to do something more with my life. You mad because you're not happy with your life, because I see more for my life. You can't get mad at me. You ought to celebrate that I'm trying to go somewhere higher than where I am right now. My brothers and sisters, the third dimension is downward comparison. And downward comparison, this is what a lot of folk like to do. What a lot of folk like to do is that we like to compare ourselves with somebody who we perceive to be beneath us. Oh my God. And most people secretly do that. And the ones who secretly do that have low self-esteem. And you know people like that, in order to make themselves feel good, then they try to put you and place you low. Y'all ain't talking back to me this morning. I know it's Resurrection Sunday. And you know they got a little smidgen of hateration in them, because whenever they start talking about your stuff, they try to ascribe the adjective little. Yeah, you think you all that with your little car. You think you got it going on with that little job. It ain't that little. If it was that little, you wouldn't focus that much on it. But because God is expanding my territory. Oh, my God. Isn't it interesting that we compare ourselves professionally, but we do not compare ourselves personally? It's easy to exchange barbs about who has a degree, who's making six figures, who's got the corner office, because we can market that or grade that in a tangible way. But it's hard to give a grade to who you are personally. Are you the best mother? Are you the best husband? Are you the best wife? Are you the best disciple? Are you the best prayer warrior? See, when I come to church, oh my God, whoever you are in the world, leave that in the parking lot. But when you come in here, I want to know one thing. When times get hard, who is the best praiser? See, some of y'all sitting there with their arms folded and legs crossed, you are out the competition. But is there anybody here who can say, if anybody can give God the glory, it's me. If you want to know what somebody who's grateful unto God looks like, look at me. He brought me from a mighty long way, made a way out of no way, picked me up and turned me around. I gotta thank God for what he's done for me. Oh my God, can I preach it like I feel it? We compare GPAs, we compare SAT results, we compare salaries, we compare square footages of homes, we compare titles, we compare physical attributes, we compare spouses. But the question I want to ask you is, for what? At the end of the day, if you make more money, it don't mean you got more favor. You might have a bigger house, but that don't mean you happy. You may drive a faster car, but if you ain't going nowhere, it don't mean nothing. You may have longer hair, but don't get it twisted. It's bag number five. Oh my God, don't even hate. For what? Do me a favor. Look at your neighbor. Tell him I'm not in competition. I'm not. Come on, look at him. Say, I'm not in competition with anybody. Look at your neighbor, tell him I'm in a class by myself. Look at your neighbor, tell him I got it going on and I don't need you to pump me up and pat me on my back and tell me I look good. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I have no competition. Oh my God, my dear friends, in John chapter 20, Jesus has already been crucified. He has already been laid in Joseph of Arimathea's tomb. And the Bible says, watch this, y'all gonna love this, that women got there first. Oh my God, I don't know how you can fix your mouth to say that women can't preach, because women were the first preachers of the gospel. Can we be in order this morning? I dare some women to just shout, he has risen. Come on, I dare some women to shout, he has risen. Oh my God. Yes, the text says in John chapter 20, verse number 3, that Mary went and told Peter and the other disciple, Jesus has arisen from the dead. And watch this, they start walking toward the tomb. And so you know that these are brothers who have high testosterone. Because Brother King, watch this, they have high testosterone, but watch what happens. They're walking, but all of a sudden they start running. They're walking toward the tomb, but something shifts between verse 3 and verse 4. In verse 3, they're walking, but in verse 4, they're running. Because the closer they get to where they're trying to go, they could not take their time. But there was something on the inside of them that wanted to accelerate the process. See, some folk can take their time getting to Jesus, but there's some people in here who can't wait to get in the presence of God. Oh my God, I want somebody in here to know that if you don't want to clap, fine. If you don't want to praise him, fine. If you don't want to shout, fine. But let me let you in on a little secret. When praises go up, that's when blessings come down. If you don't mind waiting on your miracle, sit there and be quiet. But if you need God to accelerate the process, I dare you to give him some glory, like I need you to show up right now. Hey, hallelujah. I need you to show up right now. In verse number 5, they take off running, and the other disciple beats Peter to the tomb. They're running. And the other disciple beats Peter to the tomb. It does not give us his name. It just says the other disciple. Now, every sport fan knows that on the headline of YouTube, they always show you the winner. For the old school praisers in here, every sports fan, when you used to read the newspaper, they can tell you when you read the newspaper section, the sports section, the headline always gives you the name of the winner. But there's something strange that happens in this text. It says the unnamed disciple, he got there first. This is poor journalism, because the winner should have his name in the paper. But God is showing us something about competition. See, you can't judge yourself based off of who got there first, because just because you got there first, it don't mean you won. Oh my God. See, I don't know about you, but I want my name in the paper. I want my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Let other folk get the raise first, get married first, get their book published first. But can I tell you, the race is not given to the swift or the strong, but to the one that endures until the end. Oh my God. His name is not even there. And watch this in verse number 5. And when Peter arrived, left. Oh my God. That means there was a lapse in time. It wasn't even a close race. But the thing that is wonderful about the gospel of Jesus Christ is that even though you did not finish first, he still arrived. And I don't know where you are in this room, but even though you saw other folk pass you, even so though you saw other people get their blessing ahead of you, the reason why you ought to praise him this morning is because I want to tell you, you're getting ready to arrive. The thing that you've been praying for, the thing that you've been going for God for, God says, I'm getting ready to open a door for you that no man can shut. See, some of y'all ain't been asking God for nothing, but there's somebody here who understands, I'm giving God the glory because it's almost my time. It's almost my moment. I'm getting ready to arrive. I got to get out of here, y'all. But the resurrection story is a little bit off-putting. And I know this is, for those of you who grew up in church, what I'm about to say right now, this statement won't make sense to you. But I'm going to prove it to you. The resurrection is for people, watch this, who came in second. If you always used to being on top, if you're always used to leading, always used to being up front, the resurrection ain't for you. But if you ever been through a season of your life where life tried to make you feel like a loser, God says, I'm getting ready to turn it around. There's somebody in this room who knows this must be my season because I've been faithful over a few things. God is getting ready to make me ruler over many. He goes to the tomb, ma'am. He goes to the tomb, sir. And the unnamed disciple does not go in first. And Peter goes in. He goes in, Peter does, and he sees the linen cloth. And the linen cloth is by itself. And Jesus has risen from the dead, and he left a linen cloth folded by itself. Don't forget, Peter's been running, and he's the oldest of the disciples. And Sister Leinberger, it's hot in Jerusalem, and other folk have passed him, and it's early in the morning. Oh, my God. And the other one looks back and saying, Peter, what's taking you so long? And Peter says, go ahead. I'm going to get there. I'm going to get there. I'm not in competition. I'm going to get there. I dare you to touch two people to your left and your right and tell them, I'm going to get there. I know I should have been there by now, but I'm going to get there. I'm not on your time. I'm on God's time. I'm going to get there. You touched the wrong person. I ain't preaching to everybody right now, but I'm preaching to those of you this morning. You woke up, yeah, it's Resurrection Sunday, but you tired of running, tired of being chased, tired of being on the grind, tired of trying to keep up, tired of folk trying to leave you behind, you tired of fighting folk, tired of being in situations that shouldn't have you bound, you're tired of being broke, tired of folk judging you and they don't even know you. And he finds himself in the tomb because he'd been running for a long time. Oh my God. But when he looked there, he saw a linen cloth that was there. Why was the linen cloth there? Well, I like to use my anointed imagination and say it's because Jesus knew Peter had been running, and he knew he was coming out of breath, and he knew he was going to be tired. So he left in the tomb a towel that says, I saw you when you were running. I saw everything that you were going through. But come unto me, all who are heavy laden, and I will give them rest. Can y'all help me preach real quick? Elbow your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I've been running a long time. Look on the other side, but you know what? I'm not tired yet. Because now that you got to Jesus, he's going to give you a cloth. He's going to give you some rest so you can wipe away all of the sweat
off of your brow. Is there anybody here who can say, I turned it over to Jesus and he made a way? I turned it over to the Lord and he fixed it for me. I gave it to God and he healed my body, told me to run on. He healed my body, told me to run on. He healed my body, told me to run on. Oh my God, I'm getting ready to get out of here, y'all. But you got to understand this. He leaves a linen towel there. He leaves a napkin there, and it's just there, but it's folded. Oh my God, y'all stay with me here. In Jewish tradition, when you've eaten, if the napkin is open, that means you want more of what you already had. Y'all stay with me. But if the napkin is folded, that means it's finished. Oh my God, I got to get out of here. But I came to tell somebody, your season of competition is finished. God is getting ready to give you the desires of your heart. Oh my God, can y'all help me preach real quick? Elbow your neighbor, said, neighbor, there's success at coming in second. Y'all don't believe that? Let me preach it to you. I know y'all were brought up in a season where you think you always gotta be first, but I came by here to tell you it's okay to be second. Can I tell you why? Jesus was the second Adam, because the first Adam couldn't handle sin. But when Jesus came, he said, I came that you might have life and have it more abundantly. We read today from the second testament, because the first testament said you needed a turtle dove and a bull, you needed an ox, but the second one said, as long as I got King Jesus, I don't need nobody else. We're under the second covenant, because Abraham had the first covenant, but my relationship ain't with Abraham, but my relationship is with Jesus. And because I got Jesus, I'm going to be all right. So my God, can y'all help me real quick? Help me to leave. I promise I'm going after this. Look at your neighbor. Say, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings as eagles. They shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and not faint. Oh my God, give him some glory. Like you know he's able to deliver you and heal you from where you are right now. I dare somebody to shout right now, but don't give them glory unless you got your second wind. Oh my God, you don't feel like shouting. You didn't feel like praising him. You didn't feel like giving him the glory, but you got your second wind. And when I lift up the name of Jesus, he'll make everything all right. I dare somebody to give him glory. Like Satan, we come to tear your kingdom down. Satan, we come to tear your kingdom down. I'll see y'all later, but I got one more thing to do. I came here not to compete with nobody, not to see what nobody else is doing, not to see what you wore on Resurrection Sunday, but I came with one thing on my mind, and that's to stomp the devil's balloon. Is there anybody here who wanna stomp the devil's balloon? I dare you to stand up all over the sanctuary and just start stomping, start stomping, start stomping. Come on, stomp like he won't get the victory. Stomp like the devil won't win. Stomp like everything is gonna be all right. You know why I can stomp? Because early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. Hey, hey, hey. Hallelujah. 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 I'm not in competition. I came with one thing on my mind, and that's to beat the devil today. I came with one thing on my mind, and that's to get the victory. God, if there's any day where I ought to see results, it ought to be Resurrection Sunday. God, if there's any day where I ought to see a glimpse of a reward for what I'm running for, it ought to be Resurrection Sunday. If you need something from God this morning, won't you stand all over the sanctuary on your feet if you need something from God. If you need something from God, stand on your feet. Like I need them. I'm running because I thought all hope was lost. I'm running because I thought the plan didn't work. I'm running because I thought it was too late to see a change. I thought it was too late to see a difference. God, I thought it was over. Even you said it's over. On the cross, you said it's finished. I thought it was the end. No, God says, I got something else for you. I'm not finished making a way in your life. I'm not finished blessing you. I'm not finished opening up doors for you. And if you have faith to run to where I am, I promise you it's going to be all right. If you got faith, say, I got to see this. I got to see what he's getting ready to do. I know it's coming. I want you to know God is still answering prayer. God is still listening to you. God is still trying to make a way in your life. Don't give up. Don't let go. Even if you came in last. Hallelujah. You can still win. Amen. I want to open up the doors of the church right now for somebody. Number one, you need a church home. You're not saved. You don't know Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, but you want to get to know him today. If that's you, meet me at this altar. Say, Pastor, I am not saved. I want to get to know Jesus for myself. And on this Resurrection Sunday morning, I want to give my life to Christ. If you want to do that today, come on and meet me at this altar. Come on, give the minister your hand. But more importantly, give God your heart. Secondarily, there may be somebody in the house. You want to join this church. You feel like God is leading you and calling you to be a part of this church and this ministry. And he has placed it on your heart to join us here at St. Paul. Come and meet me at this altar. And third, there may be somebody who needs prayer. If you need prayer, come on and meet me at this altar. Come on, church, let's give God some glory all over the sanctuary. Come on, come on. Hallelujah. Is there another one to come? God bless you. Another who wants to come and join St. Paul, someone who needs prayer. I know. Another who would like to come and join this morning. Hallelujah. Another.
And life is worth the living just because he lives.
Let's do that one more time. Because he lives. Brothers and sisters, Miss Chardonnay Murray has come to join St. Paul Worship Center. Amen. She is a candidate for baptism in Hendrix. Alexander Murray has come to join St. Paul Worship Center as well. Amen. And Brother Murray has been here all the time. He's come back to reunite with us. Amen. Amen. Many more has come to join us here at St. Paul Worship Center. Amen. Amen. Miss Raven Davis has come to join us at St. Paul Worship Center. Amen. 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 Let us bow our heads in a word of prayer. God, we are so grateful for those who you have called to us to be a member of our church and our congregation. We pray, God, that you will give us the tools, the insight, and the wisdom to be the best church for them. We pray, Lord God, that we will also be open to receive what they have to offer us. Help us to pour into them. Help us to grow them. And also help us to grow because of them and grow through them because of what you're doing in their life. Lord God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus for all those who are at this altar who have come for a healing. We know, Lord God, that you have healing in your hands. We also know that by your stripes, we are healed. God, I'm praying right now that your healing will manifest in the lives of everyone who's at this altar who stands in need. God, I pray that they will feel your spirit and your holy presence. I pray, God, right now in the name of Jesus, that whatever doctor appointment they have, whatever medicine that they're taking, I pray, Lord God, that it will be so effective that they will recognize and realize a change with no side effects. I pray, God, that you will, in fact, give the doctor the right mind to make the right diagnosis and prognosis and right prescription, Lord, so that they can run on and see what the end's going to be. We thank you, Lord God, right now in the name of Jesus for the harvest we've reaped today. We will forever give you the praise and the glory. And God, no man gets the glory, but you did it. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, give God some praise all over the sanctuary.
I can praise to my
after me. Say, I'm in the right place.
I'm in the right place.
At the right time.
At the right time.
With the right people.
With the right people.
Serving the right God.
Serving the right
God. Now throw your head back and say, I know that's right.
I know that's right.
Amen. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. God, head of the universe, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with these your children, now, henceforth, and forevermore.